So years ago in my youth, I used to work with a guy named Guido. And it wasn't until years later that I found out that his real name was Mark. Guido's real name was Mark. And it shouldn't have surprised me. It shouldn't have been a shock to me, because actually the place where we worked together on my name tag wasn't my real name either. See, we used to work for this large warehouse, and they used an intercom system. And they told us that when they called someone over the intercom, they wanted the right person to come. So if there was somebody already that shared your name, well, you had to change it. Which was kind of a weird thing for someone who's never had a nickname before. You know, my boss said, well, we already have a David that's working here. What else can we call you? And so the idea of naming yourself was just strange to me. You know, I'd never had a nickname, never been called anything else. And so you have this opportunity now where people are going to call you by this new name, you know? And so he's like, well, I can see this is like overwhelming to you. And he left the office. And then I'm sitting here as a young man thinking about, you know, superhero names or, you know, things that you've seen in movies and trying to come up with something macho or cool. And I couldn't do it. I couldn't think of something that I thought, this is what I want to be called. And he came back in the office and said, well, did you make up your mind yet? And the only thing I could think of was to go by my initials. You know, my first name's David, my middle name is Charles, so they called me DC. So I went by DC, it said DC on my name tag, which was not just strange for me, it was strange for like anybody who knew me. So friends or family that would come by to visit me at the warehouse, they would hear all these people, these colleagues of mine, calling me DC. And it's just strange to have that second identity. You know, you have one group of friends and family that call you one thing, and then you have another group of people that call you something else. And then you're almost living like this dual reality. And you have this almost presented opportunity to actually live two different lives. You can be this person with this name and this person with this name. And it was just a really strange, fun chapter in my life. The reason why I thought of the story, though, was because this Sunday at Walden Church, I'm actually preaching on a passage from Revelation chapter 2. And in Revelation chapter 2, Jesus says, I will give them a white stone, and it'll have a new name written on the stone that no one knows except the person who receives it. It's this idea that when we become Christians, when we become followers of Christ, we accept a new identity. Jesus gives us a new identity, a new life, a new blessing, a new name. Names are important to us, aren't they? Your name says something about you. You identify with your name. Names are important to God. They're all throughout the scriptures. Our names usually tell us something about our character, or they're a testimony all to themselves. My name is David. It's a Hebrew name. It means beloved. You probably know the definition or the meaning behind your name too. So what does your name say about you? Sometimes it's a good reflection of who we are. Sometimes it's not. Other times we do kind of name ourselves, don't we? Because we live in kind of like this place where we allow the things that are said about us to resonate and to take a foothold in us, and then we kind of live those things out. What names were you called? What labels have you been given? And have those names and those labels then influenced you in your life? Have they helped you, or have they hurt you? You see, the people that the world called tax collectors, Jesus called disciples. Those that the world called sinners, Jesus called companions. The people that were considered to be immoral, Jesus said, were forgiven. The people that were common fishermen, Jesus says, now you're fishers of men. And on the cross, Jesus took a criminal who was condemned to die, and he gave him a new name, and he says, you're an heir. You are an heir of paradise. What name have you been called? What name have you called yourself? Jesus offers you a new lease on life, a new blessing, a new name. Don't settle for the disparaging or the unflattering names that the world has given you. You don't be satisfied with any name or title that the world wants to call you. You have been given a new name by God. The one that the world knows you by, it's false. It's frivolous. There is no name better than the one that's found on the white stone that Jesus hands you. You don't need the accolades of this world. The only thing you need is the new life, the new blessing, and the new name given to you by God. This Sunday at Walden Church, we're going to talk about new names, and we're going to talk about the idea of going backwards to move forwards. It's going to be really interesting, and I hope to see you there.